All right, that's it. Christ almighty, we've got the crowd in. Family's in, mate. And well done to you guys for supporting him, because he's fantastic. And together, these guys are clearly great. And obviously, you've seen Mike as well. And together, they've got an amazing thing. They're touring around the country all the time and doing everything for this music and the music they're creating themselves. They're not boxed in any particular box, but we like to think it's gypsy jazz. You know, with a sparkle. So give these guys a massive round of applause. It's going to be a great session. It is Remy Harris, and there's Remy Harris to us.
Thank you.
Thank you. Kaylee Groves on the guitar. Mike Green on bass. That was a tune called Sissy Strut. It was from a band called The Meters. Do you know The Meters? They're from. It was written in 1969. And I guess The Meters were kind of an early funk band. Is 1969 vintage? Kind of is, isn't it? And before that was There Will Never Be Another You, which is one of my favourite old just jazz standards to just kind of warm up and not play on. Love the chord changes to that tune. Some Django fans out there? Yes. Two fingers in the air if you're a Django fan. Guess we'll just play a bit of swing for you. Thank you. Can we play a slow one for you?
Yeah.
This is a tune you've probably heard this a number of times this weekend, but it's a classic tune, and hopefully this will be a new take on it. It's a tune called Nuage. Do you know that song, Nuage? I think Gary just played it, but we were kind of hoping we'd play a few, so hopefully you're not bored of that tune already. It's a beautiful old tune, and a lot of you guys probably know the tune, perhaps even play the tune. It translates into English as clouds, and I think often when this tune is played, it's kind of considered kind of an uplifting tune, and perhaps clouds in pictures of people's mind is sometimes fluffy white clouds in a blue sky, sitting out in the sunshine playing guitar with your mates, sipping on lager, a bit like today, or coffee. And that's the kind of gypsy jazz, the romantic idea of a gypsy jazz guitar player, and other instruments, of course. And that kind of is what is associated with this music. But I always found it difficult associating that with this particular tune, because this tune, to me, is such a haunting melody. The song, if you think about it as a melody, it's got this descending melody that grinds to a halt, you know. To me, that's so heavy. And I can't think of white clouds when I play it. So I was thinking about this tune and started researching it a little bit. And this was first recorded in the autumn of 1940. And so we don't know when it was actually recorded, but it... it was recorded in the autumn of 1940, but we don't know when it was actually written, but we can guess maybe earlier that year. And of course that year, spring, summer time, was when Hitler and the Nazis marched into Paris and took over. And so maybe this song was written around that time, and we'll never know for sure. But if it was, perhaps the clouds weren't white and fluffy. Maybe they were grey and daunting, kind of descending on Paris. So with that in mind, I thought I'd come up with a new arrangement of this song that's got a bit more tension in it and maybe reflects that time, which would have been pretty horrific for anybody in Paris, but let alone a gypsy like Django. So I hope you like it, but then we'll play something happy after, so don't worry.
That was called Django's Tiger. It was based on Tiger Rag, which is old, apparently one of the first ever jazz songs. And Django, I'm not sure whether he improvised that little melody or whether it was planned, but it's kind of a tune I guess he just really liked playing on. How long have we been playing?
Thank you.
have Duke Ellington to thank for that one, and they're called Stockler Rosenberg, Rosenberg Trio. Can we slow down a bit and play some swing? Is that a yes?
Yes. Thank you.
I think it might be down to our last tune, I think. I can't remember what time we started, but... You guys must be sick of guitar playing by now. I think we should all put our hands together for Stu and Maddie and all the team. This is it's amazing. Such a cool place. How many of you guys go to have been to IGGF the past previous one? Cool, so there's some new guys here. That's cool. I don't know what the plan is for next year, but hopefully we're here again. Do you reckon? Do you feel this place? Thank you.
Thank you.